Sunday is the day very pleasant and glamorous life for the people, most of the people I think. So I would like to know that how did you spend your Sunday yesterday? Would you like to share, sir? Would you like to share that how did you spend?
Mostly social gathering, and I was having a class in the university, so I was here.
Sir, who? On a good day?
Yeah.
Would you like to share?
I was busy solving my home assignment given by my wife.
Top priority.
Sir, I was also too busy in doing my homework.
Sir.
So I couldn't hear your question about yesterday.
Yes.
Yes, that was a very nice day. Yeah. I spent some time with plants and got some gumbas from market. You know, so I was completely filled up with my kids.
Would you like to share?
Sir, it's all
about
cooking.
Let us move to Dr. Sahab. What does he say? Would you like to share?
Yeah, sure. I spent some time with the family, and most of the day I was very lazy, going to bed and waking up again. And sometimes my mother used to call me for something. And after, when the mother calls, you know, the wife has to call me again to make a balance. So something like that. The whole day went like that. But it was wonderful.
You people have shared your experiences yesterday. So here we are coming to know that what does it mean by communication? This sharing process, it is called communication. So the word communication is mostly used by the people everywhere, but a few of them, few people know that what is the actual meaning of communication and what is the actual definition of communication. So let us have a look. Through this within a short of time, we would like to confine it to the definition of communication. So the major objective of this presentation at the end of this lecture, participants should be able to explain the meaning of communication, understand the components of communication, this type of communication skills, and then learn levels of communication. First of all, we have to know that what is communication. And know that communication is a word, is a term which has been derived from the Latin language. The word, actual word is communis. Communis means to share. And here we have shared our experiences of yesterday. That way we are communicating each other. We are involved in the communication process. The actual definition is, it is a process of exchanging information, ideas, thoughts, feelings, and emotions through speech, signals, writing, reading. These are the ways. And look over at the process of communication, how does it work? First of all, the sender. Sender is the person who wants to share his ideas, thoughts, or feelings to anybody else. What happens in the mind of the sender? First of all, he generates some idea. Idea is in actual the set of some images which the sender converts into the words or any other shape or ideas or signs. So he converts those ideas into words, and then he delivers. The idea he converts or encodes, that is called message. Message he passes to through any channel. Suppose language is a channel through which he is going to transmit his ideas. Then the receiver. Who is the receiver? Receiver is the person to whom the sender is addressing. The receiver again receives his message, and then a process flows in his mind. What happens? He translates those words or that language into the images, and through this way he is decoding that. And then after decoding, he is getting the actual idea, and then he is trying to respond that. That response is named as feedback. And feedback is again a message. And he, when he passes that feedback, that message to the sender again. Sorry, that.